Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmoy Vishwas. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry and Mystery of Molecules. I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to discuss an interesting topic, that is nitroso to oxime tautomerism. Okay, and ultimately its application as a preparation of carbonyl compound. It's a very interesting compound. So what we are going to learn today? The factors which is responsible for this conversion, point number one. Point number two, how this converted into keto and its application for the preparation of 1,2-diketo compound, because we know that 1,2-diketo compounds are very reactive and they have wide number of application. So a lot of chemistry we learned in this video. So I suggest you please watch until the end, otherwise you may know the information but you may not consume or realize the logic. Because information you may forget, but if you know the logic, you will never forget. And I believe logical understanding helps a student to improve its knowledge as well as capability. Okay, so let's start to learn a new chemistry as well as interesting chemistry. See, this is known as nitroso compound. Why? Because nitroso group, you know, is attached to this. And this is known as oxime. I will come everything. This is oxime. I come how to prepare this thing in a different way. And this is keto. This thing you know very well. So let's come stepwise. So what is actually happening? This proton is shifted from here to here. See, this is happens. So that is the tautomerism shifting of proton. Now how this happens? This thing happens. This actually this is a tautomerism, means shifting of proton. Okay. So now question is, why this occurs? The main reason is the stability. Fine. Because in this case nitrogen have a double bond with oxygen, so this is the double bond. Okay. Now in this case double bond is here. Okay, now if double bond is in between two, if the electronegativity difference is higher, means double bond between carbon and nitrogen, this is a more stable compared to nitrogen oxygen double bond. Okay, so that is the main thing. Means in this case, this bond is more stable, this double bond. That is the main thing for this purpose, to transfer this proton from here to here. Okay. Means actually both nitrogen and oxygen both are highly electronegative atom, whereas carbon is not a electron. It means it's an intermediate value. That is the thing that this transfers. Okay, this fine. Now question, how this is converted? See, if you check the oxime is nothing but if you react this carbonyl with hydroxyl amine hydrochloride in presence of sodium acetate, optimum pH around 6, slightly acidic. This thing I have discussed in a separate video, that is oxime formation under optimum condition for oxime formation. Okay, so this is the oxime formation and this is actually a sheet based coupling reaction. Sheet based coupling reaction means one molecule of water is produced. So this thing you have already read. Why I gave you this information? It is always not possible to remember every reaction. But if we give some common thing or similarity, it helps us to remember. So this thing you can remember, that reaction of hydroxylamine which has an alpha effect, that is repulsion between these lone pairs, which makes this more reactive, it results. So this is the point number one. And point number two is addition reaction on carbonyl is reversible. So addition reaction on carbonyl could be reversible. Okay. So this reversibility is the logic for. And another thing, from oxidation reduction point of view, if you think. So see, this carbon got oxidized because of this tautomerization. But this is simple hydrolysis. Better to say H water means hydrolysis. What happens? See, the oxygen got attached to the less electronegative, means delta positive one. So the two hydrogen will attach to this, and actually this happens. Okay. So ultimately this resulted in keto. So this is the overall understanding about this tautomerism and conversion. By the way, when we discuss any chemistry, it is always good to learn how to prepare those chemistry. Okay, in case of acetonitro tautomerism, we know that nitro groups are very famous. So the lots of techniques you have read, I believe, in class 12 standard also. But in this case, this acetonitro tautomerism, nitroso-oxygen tautomerism, it is not that much common. So let me give you a methodology how to prepare this. Okay, such thing could be prepared by corresponding nitronium plus. Okay, so in this way you can prepare this. Let me give you a realistic example how to prepare this and what I told that PPS application for 1,2 dicarbonate preparation. So if I say 1,2 dicarbonyl, see, it is producing one carbonyl. Fine. So we have to take the compound having a carbonyl previously, such that one introduction of carbonyl makes it 1,2 carbonyl. Now, what happens? In presence of acid, we know it undergo enolization. Means you may consider this, although the equilibrium prefers to remain in the keto site. Okay, so this is the enol. I have already discussed about this ketoenol tautomerism in some previous video. Please visit if you want to learn. So this, and we told that nitronium NO plus is the electrophile. This is enol, is a nucleophilic. So this double bond is nucleophilic. And this is electrophilic. So question, they'll react. And it, how did it react? It pushes electron here and this double bond creates. So ultimately what it result? It result after that, this oxygen having this with a positive charge. And another thing, this is NO. Okay. Now, by the way, one interesting thing you observe. That previously nitrogen was having the positive charge. Right now the oxygen having, so charge balance is there. Please be careful while writing anything. Many of time we make mistake in charge balancing, so it creates confusion. And how this nitroso could be prepared? This could be prepared a very well known reaction, that is a diazotization, means nitrosation, diazotization NaNO2 plus HCl resulted in nitroso. How? This NaNO2, this NaNO2 and HCl resulted in HNO2. We know HNO2 actually looks like this. Okay, so what it does in acidic medium, that is in HCl, dilute HCl, better to say this, and low temperature. So what it does, it resulted in OH2 plus formation. And after that, it leaves to generate this. This is the overall strategy. Now, fine, we have understood. And based on this acetonitro tautomerism, what can happen? This. And by the way, one interesting point, there must be one proton. If there is no proton, tautomerization not possible. So, it is, this proton is essential. Please keep it in mind. So, this, now what is expected, that after this proton shifting, it will result this. See, this is actually 1,2 dicarbonyl thing. Okay. So, what is the understanding? First of all, enolization, nucleophilic attack, hydrolysis results in 1,2 diketo compound. Okay. By the way, one important information, you please keep it in mind, this doesn't prefer to remain in this way, rather than, this is a double bond, this is nitrogen, this is oxygen, this. Okay, because this hydrogen bonding stabilizes this compound. Intramolecular, better to say intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, so this is the overall discussion for this process. So I hope this lecture could be useful for you. This is a strategy, because we have learned this process and preparation of 1,2 diketo dicarbonyl compound. They have a wide application in synthesis. So thank you for watching this video. If you really like my teaching, and if you think this teaching is deserved, then please subscribe my channel, Chemistry and Mystery of Molecule, and please press the bell icon to get the notification of every new video I upload. Secondly, share this video with your friends so that they can also enjoy my teaching. And most importantly, please like the video and make some good comments to encourage me, and such that I can make such kind of videos for you. So till now, stay happy, stay blessed. See you in my next video.